Well, let's start with March. Obviously, you know, it was going to be a Cinderella story. You know, you had this amazing opportunity to step in. Things didn't go your way, but just kind of relive it. I mean, any regrets? Did you enjoy it? What was it like for you?
I guess my only regret is like not being in shape, but you know, I fought 4 weeks before it, 3 weeks before getting the call up. I'd been on holidays for 2 weeks after that, and just working my shift work job, and obviously, you know, we talked about it last time I got a call up at work. So, you know, I was just doing my thing, just working and holidaying, and I'd actually only been back at the gym for like a week. So I'd trained like 3 days around my shifts when they called me up. But, you know, it's an opportunity you don't knock back. So in hindsight, it would have been nice to, you know, be in a little bit better shape. Would have also made my weight cut a lot easier. But, you know, it is what it is. You know, you make the most of the opportunities. I think, you know, all by getting the W, I made the most of my opportunity. You know, I think I threatened submission-wise a lot. You know, this guy was multiple-time world champion black belt. I had no idea when I went into the fight that he'd won any jiu-jitsu world titles. So, yeah, I found out afterwards. And, you know, there's a few things that, you know, I wish I had a finish. I'm in deep Kimura. You know, I had the legs set up, my position, my body position, everything was good. You know, afterwards going over it with my coaches, you know, I was probably like an inch here or there of actually finishing it. So I think I proved, if anything, a 3-round fight of being held down that, you know, I can hang with them. You know, sure, I got held down. I didn't really have the legs in me, you know. That's one thing I didn't expect, was that after that weight cut, I felt fine. You know, I'd rehydrated. I was back up to 175, and I felt good. You know, someone said to me, oh, how's your legs feel? I'm like, no, they feel fine. You know, I'm good to go. And it wasn't until like halfway through the first round, I was like, oh, my legs aren't fine. You know, that I couldn't scramble. And scrambling is probably what I would consider, and most that I talk to, would be one of my biggest assets. If the scramble creates, then I'm going to win it. You know, so I couldn't do that in that fight, and that's why he was on top of me. You know, but I looked for the finish when I was on feet, so it was, you know, it was exciting. I don't think he wanted to stand with me.
Yeah, so now you get a chance to do it a second time around. I wonder, like, is there a little bit of confidence knowing that you did prove some things there, or is there a feeling of pressure knowing that, you know, you got one chance, you probably only get two? I mean, what is the feeling going into this one?
No, man, you know, I think the guys that get two chances and get booted, you know, sometimes just have two really bad performances. You know, I think I'm not really thinking about it. You know, a lot's changed for me since last time. Not just in fight preparation, but just in life. So much has changed for me positively that, you know, it doesn't even come in my mind. Like, literally, you asking me the question, it's like, you know, I got to think about it. Like, it's not in my mind that if I lose two, you know, I'm not going to get that opportunity again. Because I know that, you know, all bar catching me with a shot, this fight's going to be a war, regardless, because I don't have anything else. I can tank punishment and I can give punishment, and I'm happy to grapple with whoever. I think everyone's seen that last time. So, you know, I feel like my grappling, my coaches feel like my grappling and my striking's gotten better since last time. More importantly, I've taken 8 weeks off what normally was a full-time job. So I've been off work for 2 months now. My work's been fantastic. Gave me the time off on short notice and, well, like reasonably short notice, you know, that I 4 weeks from wanting it and they gave me 2 months off. So, I've had my first ever full-time training fight camp in my career. So that's positive in itself. You know, I took a lot out of the last fight. You know, I don't think he can out-grapple me, his style. I don't think he can out-strike me. Yeah, I think this fight's going to be a lot of fun. A lot of things have changed for me. So
you mentioned taking 8 weeks off. Obviously, you work in the prison system there in Australia. So is this kind of a crossroads for you? I mean, is that something that you can continue to do, is take time off for a full camp? Or is this kind of a chance to evaluate, you know, am I going to be a full-time fighter and not have a full-time job?
You know, like, I've established myself outside of fighting. I think that's why I'm comfortable with, you know, not worrying about if I lose. Because, you know, I've got a house, I've got a job, I've got a wife. You know, I've established myself. You know, fighting's not going to, you know, winning fights and making lots of money is not going to build my life. I'm building my life outside of fighting. So fighting for me is, you know, I would love for it to be full-time. Don't get me wrong. that's the end goal, you know. Win two or three more fights and then, you know, take a year off. Just progressively build it, you know. At the moment, my work, I got a great boss. You know, he said, you know, that I can have the time off for the fights if they can manage it. And what I can't, I've got great colleagues. They work my shifts in between. So it's definitely at least for the next two fights, I'll be looking at taking 6 to 8 weeks off for fight camps, just going back to work in between. And they seem happy with that, and I'm more than happy to do that. You know, they work with me, I work with them, kind of thing. And, you know, we'll see what happens. I'm not looking too far ahead, but, you know, a couple of wins and could be a year off, you know what I mean? So we'll just see what happens.
Nice. Talk about the matchup itself. Obviously, a guy that's kind of relatively new as well. So how do you feel you guys match up?
I've only looked at his last fight twice. I don't really study fighters. I just sort of look at their fight and maybe see how aggressive they are and what their striking style is, and maybe their grappling style if I can see it. You know, I think he's game. You know, he'll stand in the pocket and he'll trade, but I think he's pretty straight, you know, back and forth. You know, I think I can expose him on the feet. You know, he showed in his last fight he can be knocked out. I haven't seen any others. Looking at his record on Zhurdog, he's got like a couple of guillotine finishes. You know, I'm fine with that. It's sort of like my go-to, you know, submission is not really finishing the guillotine, but using that front choke, chin grip position is like my go-to, you know. So to have a favourite position, you also got to have the defences to that. So that way, you know, like if I know how they're going to defend it for me to finish it, then, you know, I sort of learn those defenses as well. So I'm pretty confident that, you know, he's not going to try and hold me down. He's a finisher. You know, he looks to finish. So I don't think it's going to work out too well for him.
Sounds like you're pretty confident, pretty comfortable. I mean, are there moral victories here? I mean, it sounds like you kind of took a moral victory out of last time, or is this really about going in and making sure you get the W?
No, man. I've every intention on going in, getting the win, but not just getting the win, but I want to go in there and finish the fight inside too and set the standard for the card. You know, there's a lot of tough fights on this card. You know, Matt Brown brings it every time. Robbie Lawler brings it every time. I mean, fighters come to the UFC and they see the fact that they can win performance bonuses and stuff. I mean, one of those changes a life, you know what I mean? So I'm not going in there just to get a W, you know. I'm not going to lay on the guy. I don't have that style. I'm not going to point spar him. I don't have that style either. So I'm going in there to finish it. I'm going in there to set the standard for the card. So yeah, that's what I'm looking forward to. I'm really sort of relishing the opportunity to actually open the card. So it's going to be good.